This video is brought to you by CuriosityStream and Nebula. Get more tool recommendations in the extended cut of this video, exclusively on Nebula. Tired of your webcam settings resetting every time you reboot? Want to access their settings outside of OBS? How about an overlay that shows when viewers redeem channel points on Twitch, so you can actually have them featured in the stream too? Today's free OBS Tools video covers all of this and more. We got some neat stuff. I'm EposVox, and I have countless videos showcasing cool OBS plugins, scripts, and side tools to maximize your stream, and we're jumping in with number one in today's video. We have DXpoints Notification. This is a simple browser source overlay that displays an alert or notification whenever someone redeems channel points on your Twitch channel. While channel point redemptions typically, announce themselves in chat or do something to your stream, there isn't typically a way to actually just kind of alert or call them out whenever they do redeem them. So this gives you an easy way to highlight when someone actually utilizes, channel point redemptions in your stream visually, which is pretty cool. Log into the authorization page, then copy the URL into a browser source, and you're good to go. It features a sound effect and a neat little animation, but it's not super customizable yet. These features are planned, but given there aren't many alert options for channel points specifically anyway, it's pretty neat, and I've already seen quite a few channels who actually utilize this in their streams. Secondly, we have CounterAnimate. This one's less of a big deal than the others, as it requires other tools to update and utilize, but it takes the usual updating text files capability of OBS Studio, which would be used for scorecards, countdown timers, etc., and actually animates that number from one update to the next instead of just having a static jump between them to make it more interesting. That being said, it's just not a simple thing. It requires you to run a local Apache web server just to get it to show up, and then it just falls in the probably not worth it category, but I thought I would highlight it and see if anyone does anything cool with it. Next up is a really awesome tool, CamooZ. CamooZ is a tool that allows you to manage, save, and restore your webcam settings. For a lot of webcams, the only way to adjust exposure and things like that is by going to the Video Capture Device Properties menu in OBS Studio, and then they don't persist past reboot. CamooZ. It's a dedicated tool to access and manage these settings outside of OBS, but then allows you to take that even further and saves them to a dedicated profile file with the ability to load them back up after reboots and things like that. Very nice, and probably crucial if you use a traditional webcam regularly. If you don't want to mess with this, there is a little script called Webcam Settings Dialog for Windows, which will pop up the same UVC settings menu that OBS opens. You run the bat file to find your webcam device name, then put that name in the webcamdialog.bat file, and then you create a shortcut to that, and you can access the menu whenever you'd like. This is super useful for editing webcam settings for video conferencing, but doesn't save them. CamooZ is probably the better choice overall, but I wanted to feature both, give you options. The author of the CamooZ tool also made a tool called CamRename. It does as the name implies. It loads a list of direct show webcams connected to your computer and lets you rename them with backups made in case you need to undo this change. This just edits the device name in the registry, but it's nice to have, and it's a handy tool that does it for you. This is super useful if you have multiple of the same webcam on the same system or multiple other similar devices that way you can easily identify them when you're setting up your stream and things like that, instead of just being like, okay, which C920 is which or what have you. Especially useful for big multicam setups. Giving you a backup option in case something goes wrong is important, as messing with registry names for devices can get funky, but otherwise, this is really handy. Our next tool is a secret, but one you'll want to know if you use Discord to record your podcasts or videos. It takes those recordings to the next level to give you more control. You can learn about it over on my own streaming site I built with my creator friends. The site is called Nebula, and we've partnered with CuriosityStream. Nebula features YouTube's top education creators such as Low Spec Gamer, wonderful human being, the channel's probably going to be called something else soon, Thomas Frank, and MKBHD. My videos are higher quality there, ad-free, and often extended from the YouTube versions, like this one. You know what also has top-tier educational content, though? CuriosityStream. They wanted to partner up, so we've bundled our services, so you get both sites for the price of one, and that price is so affordable, it should be illegal. By signing up with the link below, you not only get access to CuriosityStream's library of thousands of educational and documentary titles, but you also get access to Nebula and all of our educational experiences over there too. Crash Course just got added to CuriosityStream, so you can watch Andre Meadows teach you about the history of gaming going all the way back to ancient Egypt. To get the best bundle in streaming, head on over to curiositystream.com/epos and get a special bundle discount at 26% off an annual plan, making it only $14.79. That's less than $15 for an entire year of amazing content. You can't beat it. 2021 was a crazy year, and I want to make sure that this year is focused more and more on getting the most out of your stream with the software and tools available to you. OBS's functionality is expandable beyond your wildest dreams, and hopefully I continue to help show you that with these plugins and tools videos. Apologies for the wacky background. We have been having some electricity problems here in the studio, so things are kind of haywire for the moment, but I hope your year is starting out strong. Remember, be kind, rewind.